hopefully it will lead to some of the meaningful, you know, products which will come. Okay.
Thank you.
Sorry, my bad throat. I mean, of digital, you know, IoT and digital applications, which can help improve the efficiency, which can help improve the, you know, supply chain systems, which can also improve the safety, which is, I think these are the various aspects which are being examined, and most of our companies are looking at the applications of digitalization, and also the, you know, what you said is that digitalization application in total, blockchain, etc., and data analytics, how they can improve their business processes. I think these are the things which are already being looked into by the way.
John?
Yeah, if I merge these last two questions, I think it's really important. One, accelerators work, right? The ability to take a long IT base that can link to your energy sector means you can actually gain disproportionate returns for VCs in the combined energy digital space. So I think very carefully about how exactly you can stimulate that environment through a combination of accelerators, incubators, and targeted funding for cross-digital energy applications. But that's not enough, right? We need hard tech as well within the energy space. And that's where we come back to this observation around petroleum companies and VC funds, because energy strategics are the natural owners of the energy transition investment funds here. They understand the industry, they're willing to put the money at risk. You can all benefit in the process of this transition by taking stakes in individual companies, and especially when you take stakes in de-risked ways where you have accelerators that are moving these companies quickly toward successful customers, successful investments, successful mentorship through your relationships with them, the whole system works a lot better. That's one way to think about bridging the gap between really the technological and the research prowess that India has and the entrepreneurial market success that India has. You need to pull those two together with this ecosystem that sits there right in the middle of technology risk and digital applications and build a vibrant sector there. Huge opportunity for the country.
Thank you. I think a number of speakers said that oil and gas players will become energy players of the future, whatever be the source of energy. And I would even venture to say energy plus mobility, or energy plus other services. So there's opportunity for all of us in here. With that, I will thank my distinguished panelists. It's been a really invigorating and lively discussion. Thank you very much to the audience for the questions and your thoughts. And I'll close it here. Thank you.
The water will come, and she would demand that we should first look at where the faucet should go and how the shower should look like, and how many water points should be there. So I somehow feel it's almost similar. Do we look at data lakes and integration, or do we look at how the customer and the other users will be there? There are also other different debates, and how it's changing the world, how it's changing the ecosystem partners, and then is it just about technology? So with that, I think I sort of rethemed this around is digital a buzzword still, or is it something real? Before I go on with my discussions with the panelists today, just want to mention that there was a session on the pre-Petrotech on the 8th for in the subject, and that is available in your app. We have actually a stall or a booth on that, and then there are also different write-ups in the book which is published by the Oil and Gas